Friends, welcome back to Civil Engineering Mastery. Today in this video we are going to discuss about how do we check the deflection in two-way slab using StatPro software. So let's model the slab in the StatPro software and then check the deflection. So now let's start doing the model. So we have the slab size of 3.35 by 4.42 meter. The same let's model in the stat. Let's open stat, select space, give next, add beam. The unit is in meter and kilonewton. Add beam, finish. So now we have the node here. So from this we can model the slab. So select this node, we have to create a rectangular slab, Control C. So in X direction, we can give 3.35, which was the shorter direction. And next again, in Z direction, we have 4.42. So now we can connect this. Then now this one also we can copy and paste in next direction, 3.35 meters. And again we can draw beam using beam cursor. So now we got the rectangular slab. So next let's add the plate element. So we have to select the plate cursor and then add plate. Plate is added now. Before messing the plates, we can assign the member properties. So go to commands, member property, prismatic. So here we can add the beam size. So rectangle 0.2 by 0.45. Sorry, this is the depth. And then this is the width. So 200 by 450 is the beam size that we can add. And then close and even thickness we can add. Plate thickness. I'm going to take 125 mm. So add. Next, we can assign the beam size. So these four beams are assigned as. Beam size is assigned and then even plate thickness we can assign. Okay, now properties are done. Next, what we have to do is we have to mesh this plate. Right click, give generate plate mesh for regular meshing. So here we can give 4. So we are making it as a 4x4 mesh. So it has come like this. So properties are assigned. Now we have to provide the support conditions. So this slab is having the condition of two adjacent edges discontinuous. So this edge and this edge is discontinuous and this side and this side is continuous. So let's assign the support conditions. Go to support specifications, select pinned, add, and then again fix add. So we have two support conditions. So we can, we have, so this side I'm going to give as a hinged support. Which is assigned. This side select all the nodes and then assign fixed support. So now member properties are done. We are and support conditions also done. Let's assign the loads now. So go to comments, loading. dead load. Give add and then live load. Give add. So we have both dead load and live load. Next we have to assign the loads. So dead load, under dead load we can add member load, that is 12 kilonewton per meter as a wall load all around the slab, that we can add. And then plate pressure we have to apply on the slab. The partition load and floor finish load will come, so that we, so 1 kilonewton per meter square we are adding as a partition load, and then again 1 kilonewton per meter square is floor finish load. So this is all about dead load. So this much will come, and we have to add self weight as well. Let's add. Now we have to add the self weight. So self weight load we are adding. So this is all about the dead load. Now we have to add the live load, which is 2 kilonewton per meter square, that we have to apply on the plates. So that's all. So we can assign all the loads now. See, the wall load is added, and then plate pressure we have to select the plates, assign to select plates, assign the partition load, and then next again we have to add the finish load. That is also added, and next let's add the live load. You have to select all the plates and then add. So live load is also added. Next we have to assign the self weight. So self weight is assigning for beams, and then we can select all the plates. So all the loads are assigned now. Next let's add the load combinations. Go to start editor mode. So here type load combinations. Load combination 3, which is 1 times dead load plus live load. Next 1 and 2. Next, let's add load combination 4, which is 1.5 times dead load plus live load. So that is 1 times 1.5, 2 times 1.5. So that's all. Load combinations are added. Let's check here. So we have the load combinations as well. So everything is done now. Now let's start the analysis. Go to comments, analysis, perform analysis, give all, then analyze, run analysis. So analysis is done. Go to post processing mode. Select 1 times dead load plus live load. If apply, okay. So now let's check the deflection. Usually we have to check the deflection at center, which is the place where we get the maximum deflection. So this is we have 0.611 mm. You can see that is the maximum deflection we got, 0.611 mm. So now let's see the control of deflection from IS456 class number 23.2. So that gives the condition that the deflection should not exceed normally span by 250. That means we have to check with the ratio span by 250 and then span by 350. So there are two conditions, or 20 mm, whichever is less. So lesser of span by 250 or span by 350 we have to consider, and we can cross check that deflection value with the TATRO results. Maximum deflection from TATRO software we got as 0.611 mm. As per IS456 class number 23.2, we have the deflection limit as span by 250 or 20 mm, least of the above. So here we have to check with span by 250. So we have the shorter span dimension as 3350 mm divided by 250, so which gives 13.4, so which is less than 20 mm. So this one we have to take for comparison. So 13.4 is greater than 0.611, which we got from TATRO. So whatever the deflection we got from the TATRO is within the limit. So friends, hope you all like this video. Please do comment in the comment box and don't forget to subscribe this channel for more videos. Thank you for watching.